Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my new subscribers. Thanks for being here, I appreciate you guys. So I posted on my community board a couple of days ago requesting for you guys to just give me your suggestions of what readings you want to hear next. So this is one of them. I'm going to go through the list. If some of you haven't already done it and you want to hear something that I've not done or you want to hear again, go over to the community board and put it in there and I'll go through the list. Okay, so obviously by the title, this is how is your ex doing with the third party. So for group one, we have the Fool, and it says exploration. Then we have group two, the Magician, inner skills. And then for group three, we have the Justice, equality. Okay. So take what resonates, leave what doesn't, don't force anything, and and remember these are energies as well. You can swap them around, you can chuck out what doesn't resonate, you know, all that kind of jazz. Okay, so I'll see you at your piles. Hey group one, so if you chose the Fool, so with this card, okay, from what I'm picking up from the energy here of with your ex, obviously with the Fool, it's taking a chance, isn't it? You know, taking that leap, not knowing what's going to come between, you know, this ex and the third party. But I'm also picking up with this energy that they may have been unprepared for what they got, if you know what I mean. And I shouldn't laugh, but you know, at least they're a trier, you know. So yeah, I feel like this energy here was a bit unprepared for with the reality. Yeah, I feel like they're picking up that they feel like they may have been a bit reckless. So let's have a look. I don't know why I didn't get my thing to slot it in, but never mind. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do tarot, and then I'm going to get oracle cards, plus I'm going to also get a message from the third party to you, but I don't know whether to start with it. Sometimes I get drawn to do something, but I have my hand on it there, and Spirit say no, leave it till after. So I'm going to leave it till after. So Spirit, please tell me for group one, how is the ex and group one's ex and the third party doing? How is their relationship going? Jeez, not that many, Spirit. Bloody hell. Like giving me their life story. Right, that's better. So we have... Oh, okay. Okay, straight away, we have the Seven of Swords. Seven of Swords speaks to someone that is being deceitful, okay? They're lying, they're cheating, they're stealing, they're trying to get away with something. But also, I'm wondering whether your ex is also... So if this ex of yours left you for this third party, cheated with this third party, I feel like this is happening again, okay? Because the Seven of Swords is the most sneakiest energy in the deck. It also could be that they're trying to avoid problems in the relationship, you know, maybe they're not fighting back. Like I said, I'm picking up a bit of, they regret being so foolish, if you know what I mean. So tell me about the Seven of Swords. What's going on here with the third party and the ex? Tell me about the Seven of Swords. So we have the Nine of Wands, the Page of Cups, the Eight of Cups. Okay. Seriously? The overall energy is the Two of Pentacles, and I do want to clarify the Two of Pentacles, because what I'm seeing here, there's two scenarios, okay? It either could be they're doing the same thing to this karmic. I'm going to call this the karmic, okay? or the third party. Sometimes it's easy to say karmic. But anyway, so what I'm seeing here is they're either doing the same thing to them, the third party, okay, cheating on them and trying to get away with it, okay, because my two of pentacles are seen as juggling. Or it could be that there's just too much responsibility for this person. Maybe they got involved with someone that has too many issues, too many problems, you know, and they're having to juggle work, you know, finances, relationships, and it's just got a bit too much. And I just heard a car zoom down the road, and I feel like this is what this energy is doing. They're ready to escape. I shouldn't laugh, but it's like, I love that saying, what goes around comes around, because it's so true. It really is. They're experiencing they've experienced some kind of hurt here, okay? This relationship has not made them happy at all. It's either that they were very naive when they entered this connection, like I said, weren't really prepared for what they were truly getting, okay? I feel like they didn't really know the third party very well. They just jumped in. I think it was based on sex, okay? But I am seeing, this energy is trying to protect themselves from something here, like, you know, maybe the backlash that's going to come with it after all the trouble that they caused, because we do have the Eight of Cups. The Eight of Cups is walking away, or this person's withdrawn from the connection, but they're actually, they're wanting to walk away here. But I feel like they're not going to do it in an honest way. Just like they didn't do it in an honest way with you, group one. This person doesn't know how to be honest. They're so freaking childish. Because with the Page of Cups, this is someone who is still emotionally stunted. Doesn't know how to be an adult. So once again, the sneaky behaviour just carries on in this X's energy here. It's just sneakiness. Ugh. Okay, tell me about the Two of Pentacles here. Why is this here? You know, apparently this energy is saying as well that it's taking a lot of courage to actually leave this third party behind. Oh, we have the Ten of Pentacles. Okay, because I'm clarifying the Two of Pentacles. And then we have, oh dear, yeah, they've got involved with someone that they was not ready for. The Queen of Swords in reverse. Look at this, the Lovers as well, guys. They were not prepared for somebody that they got involved with here. You know, I feel like the third party showed a side of them that was nice and caring and loving and, I don't know, all that people like to show. And then obviously when they got behind closed doors and this ex of yours got involved with this Queen of Swords, they got a big reality check right in the face. They got someone who is very rude, very malicious, has a right nasty streak, okay? The Queen of Swords can also be a cheater, but she's obsessed with your ex here. I'm on about obsessed. Queen of Swords. She's bitchy, okay? And now, I said about this person doesn't know how to, I mean, this can even be your ex, but I'm seeing it more as the fact that you got involved with someone, I suppose, like attracts like, really. I feel like these two are two peas in a pod. I really do. Both immature, have communication problems, don't know how to communicate with one another, okay? So then there's the lashing out part. this Queen of Swords as well is also accusing your ex of doing something behind their back, okay, being juggled here. There is, from what I'm seeing, somebody else in the picture here for your ex that they're either communicating with, you know, and, you know, they're doing the dirty here with your lovers. Yeah. Yeah. And your ex is saying basically that they made a poor choice here, okay? They feel, I don't know, maybe feeling a bit lonely. But all they've had is drama in this connection. They've not had a good time. So, you know, and they're wanting to walk away. So I do want to actually, let me find out. Tell me about this Eight of Cups. Yes, yeah, got toxic. Death is here. Judgment call. So we do have the Devil, okay? This is for the Eight of Cups, the King of Cups, and Death, okay? And then we do have Judgment on the back of the deck. Now, they're trying to find the strength to walk away. They may already have walked away. You may have heard about this, but they now realize that this Queen of Swords and your ex is toxic for one another, okay? It was based on just sexual attraction, okay? But I don't know why I'm getting that this ex of yours is addicted to the Queen of Swords. So that's why they're finding it really hard to walk away from this relationship here. And it's like they want a second chance to do it right, I feel like, but they're not, they're really not doing it right, because they've got someone in the background here that they're ready to move on for. I feel like this ex of yours can't be alone, group one. It's like they don't know how to be alone. I feel like they have codependency issues when it comes to getting involved with someone. It's like when they get involved with someone, they latch on really tightly. It's like you are their world. But then when they get into this connection, it's like then the reality sets in that actually that's not what I want. So if anything, I'm really seeing that it's your ex that's the one that's lost in life, okay? They have all this love to give, but they're still very immature with the King of Cups. They're emotionally immature. There's something that got stunted along the way. But, you know, the Eight of Cups clarifies the Death card here. This is them ending. They want to change things. They want to move on, okay? They want to close this chapter. But they're being judged for their past mistakes here. It's like, I feel like with Judgment here, they can't seem to get away from this pattern that keeps going on in their life because they keep making the same mistakes over and over again. So it's like Spirit is stepping in and saying, until you change who you are, you change your behavior and the way you treat people, you're going to keep going around and around and around in circles, meeting these toxic devil energies. So now I'm going to get the oracle cards, okay? Because I do want to say, let's have a look. This is the third party cards. So tell me, Spirit, about group. Hang on, group ones. Oh. Can't read all those. Tell me about group one's ex and the third party. Yeah, I feel like there's going to be like a big explosion here between the both of them, because the way the cards are just like, it's not just a couple, it's just they're flying out in clumps basically. So I feel like there's going to be this big blowout between the both of them. Turn out the third party and group one's ex, thank you. We have avoiding sex. Trying to be loyal to one person, no sex life with current partner, fear of intimacy. Now, what I'm getting from this is if they are juggling somebody else with the karmic, okay, the third party, they're avoiding the sex with the third party, and maybe this is why the Queen of Swords has come out in reverse, because she's being suspicious, she's accusing your ex of being up to no good, you know. How can you trust someone when they came to you knowing that they were already cheating on my group ones? You can't really, can you? You can't 100% trust them. So your ex is avoiding sex with the karmic. Wow. Thanks for clarifying, spirit. We've got leaving someone behind, ending a love triangle, tired of the emotional mess. There you go. They're walking away. But I feel like they're not walking away from the juggling. They're walking away from the Queen of Swords and moving towards the other third party. Oh, God, what a hot mess. Jesus, how can people literally find the energy to cheat? I'm sorry, I don't know. My husband's enough as it is. I could never imagine somebody, like, having someone else on the side and having to deal with their crap. But obviously, this energy... Oh, I don't know. I feel like they are getting fed up with it. I feel like they feel with the second third party that it's going to work out. But spirit's saying, no, no, it's not. You keep attracting these devil energies and it's going to happen till you change. Okay, so quite a few came out there, so let's have a look. So we've got ghosting, avoiding confrontation, stringing you along, A's, A, plan B, emotionally immature. Thank you again for clarifying. Now, this energy could have ghosted you, but what I feel like what's going to happen with, because this is about the third party, is I feel like they're just going to sneak off. You know, like when I said about the car, I feel like they may end up just ghosting this third party because they're too, I was going to swear, they're too chicken shite, you know. Too late. Feel it's too late to fix things. Feel pressure to make a decision. Taking a long time to decide. Exactly. They're to and fro with their emotions, with their thoughts here. They're going backwards and forwards. Who should I be with? Who do I not want to be with? But they will come to a final decision here with judgment. Protection. Using protection. Risk of getting pregnant. Possibly STD. So this energy knows to use protection. You know, maybe they caught something before. You know, maybe they don't want to risk that again. Maybe they don't want to get someone pregnant. Or if it's, female, they don't want to get, you know what I mean. Unexpected events, sudden change, unplanned love affair. Exactly. So, you know, this person's really draining my energy because she's just getting on my tits. Anyway. How did you cope with this ex group one? This ex is so all over the place. It's like, I don't know whether you guys heard about magpies, okay? Magpies like shiny new things, like, or any shiny object, okay? So it's like a magpie sees something shiny and they've got to have it. And this is like this energy here. They see something shiny walking by and it's like, oh, I've got to have it, I've got to have it. Yes, it was unexpected, but... Oh, this energy's got a lot to learn. Anyway, the heart leads. Follow the heart, choosing to be happy, no longer hiding their feelings. Yeah, see, that's the problem. They use their heart instead of their head. They don't think with their head. And hard to get. Rejection, not settling for less, playing hard to get. So the person they may be involved with, the other third party, you know, the one they're juggling, maybe playing hard to get, and that might be what the attraction is. There's more to this story, secrets and lies, not who they claim to be, half-truths, and that can be the King of Cups. He can be someone who likes to play emotional games, you know, emotionally manipulative as well. So I want to get a message from the third party to you, because I'm sure... this third party's heard about you guys. So spirit, tell me please for group one, what does the third party want to say to group one? Recognizing, acknowledging and accepting we have fallen out of love. So this is the karmic that is telling you this. Okay, what more does this karmic want to say to group one? Users, handouts, takers. So they could either be telling you that they're the user, they like handouts, or your ex is the user. Arguments or problems that don't get resolved. Yeah, which we've seen this anyway, guys. Literally seen it. get a couple more from the karmic. Options and choices more than one. I'm sure you have options too. He's not the only one in your life. And that is the thing. The karmic is saying to you that... I feel like the karmic knows, the third party knows that there is somebody else. And that's why the accusations are coming from the Queen of Swords to your ex here. Because this energy knows that they're up to no good again. And that's what the karmic is saying to you here. They have other options. I'm not just the only one. You know, just like you weren't the only one. One more. All right, two more then. So releasing, letting go of all the drama. So the karmic saying that they want to release this relationship. I feel like you don't need to. I feel like they're going to do a runner anyway. And not you, I'm talking to the karmic, like they can hear me. Meaning that the karmic doesn't need to do nothing because I feel like this person is going to be... doing a runner without saying anything. Drunken indulgence, bar hugging, groupie. That was on the back of the deck just now. So this could be somebody that the karmic is someone that is a bar hugging groupie, okay? So let's have a look. Tell me more about the third party and group one's ex, please. Tell me more about their relationship. What is going on? So we have secret past, skeletons in the closet, not telling the whole story. So, which we've obviously seen that this ex of yours has a secret past. I mean, it could be that they tell half truths. Unpredictable, never know what they'll do. Unreliable, live wire. Now come on, we've just seen this. This energy is so unreliable. I feel like they don't even know what they want. Up in the air, not able to make solid plans, flighty, ungrounded. Ow, don't even need to explain that card. Vicious circle. This is what I was saying. It's like what goes around comes around. It's like repeating the same cycle over and over and over again. And this is why judgment is here, because spirit is saying until you learn that bloody lesson, you are not going to be free of these kind of relationships, okay? Which is the devil. So we've got vicious circle, pattern of relationship issues, bad habits, no win situation. Guys, I know you may be hurting, okay? Group one, little lecture coming on. You may be hurting, but seriously, come on. You've had a lucky escape, okay? This person's not emotionally available or emotionally mature enough to handle themselves, let alone a connection. Mechanical, going through the motions, checked out, routine, exactly, and that is avoiding the sex situation as well as just going through the motions with this Queen of Swords here. Well, this one was a bit of a juicy one. So let's have a look. The last cards here. So tell me more about... Okay, look at this. Sneaky behaviour, spying. They are snooping, hoping to get more information on you. So maybe they are actually spying on you to see what you're doing, but... It could be that the Queen of Swords is spying on your ex here to see, you know, because it's mainly about these two, not you guys, okay? We're just being nosy. So we have manipulation. They will make you feel guilty when you don't give them their desires. Manipulation. I feel like that is the Queen of Swords, though. I said about being manipulative and controlling, okay? But then this could be... No, it's the Queen of Swords energy I'm picking up here. I can't stop laughing at this card. I mean, look at the way he's hiding in the closet. I don't know why I'm seeing your ex pretending to be asleep, you know, or, you know, I've got a stomachache or I don't feel well to avoid this situation. Anyway, Lies, lies, lies. Artificial love. They don't really love you, just stringing you along. Exactly. And that's what we've seen in this reading. They do not love the third party at all. It's just a convenience at the moment till they can escape. So, my lovely group ones, I hope this helped or, you know, brought you some comfort here. And anyway, you have a lovely day. Much love, guys. Hey, group two. So, if you chose the magician... So with your ex and the third party here, what I'm seeing here is this energy may be surrounded in confusion at the moment. Maybe they're confused about the third party. It also could be that they feel like the third party has no imagination at times. You know, they've not really got nothing about them. Okay. We also could look at this that your ex is manipulating the third party, okay? They're very greedy. They could be wearing a mask. It's like a bit of a mind control here, okay? But let's have a look. Whoever it is, though, your ex is very clever, okay? They're good at manipulating someone or certain situations. They've just got that way about them. But this could also be the third party doing this to your ex, but we'll see. So tell me, spirit, how is group two's ex and the third party getting on? How's their relationship, spirit? Someone is greedy in this relationship. The Fool. Tell me, okay. Do you know what? I don't know why I'm not even going to explain it. Or maybe I should. Before I started doing your cards, I don't know why I thought of having to tell you lot to go to group one, okay? And the same cards have come out. I don't know why. Don't ask me why. That was there. Go over and check out group one, guys. I think there may be a similar situation. It may be like a crossover. But we do have the same cards. Whoever this was, they were naive when they got into this connection, okay? They wanted to take a chance, you know, but they weren't prepared for what they were actually getting. What they were getting was somebody that lies a lot, okay? They steal, they can be greedy, they could be cheating. But now this energy is like, I'm stuck. Now we do have the Two of Cups on the back of the deck. Now this, it could be a karmic soulmate connection between the both of them. But this, your ex does love this energy here, but somebody is being sneaky. Someone is not being honest here. Someone feels used. Someone has become disinterested. They've disconnected from the connection here, and it's like, disconnected. Tell me about the Seven of Swords and the Hangman, please, spirit. The Moon, illusions, secrets, Seven of Wands, Prince of Cups, which is the Knight of Cups, the Emperor, and the Three of Swords. Someone's cheating. Yeah, go check out group one. You know, Six of Pentacles is equal give and take. It's also given to other people, you know, giving to somebody else. And this is what I'm seeing here once again with this group. So, somebody has feelings for someone else here, which is a third party. And I'm picking up it is a masculine energy, okay? It doesn't matter with what sex you are. Everyone has masculine and feminine, but this is a strong masculine energy. This is somebody who is the provider, okay? The one that looks after the home and the family. This ex of yours could be married now to this third party, okay? They could be a parent now. But what's happening here is this Emperor is giving, they're going on secret you know, rendezvous, is it rendezvous, like secret get-togethers, you know, maybe sneaky hotels and things like that. And this could even be a work affair, okay? But there is a third party involved with your ex with somebody else. And they're trying to keep this hidden from the one that they're supposed to be with. And they're trying to protect this secret here. They're trying to make sure that it's not going to come out. So they're having a secret affair with somebody else. And if you're sitting there thinking, well, no, that's what happened to me. No, this is not about you guys. Okay, I don't say that in group one. It's not about you guys. We're here to be nosy. Okay, you're here to see what is going on between their relationship now. This is about their connection. Okay, so this is... this is them. Tell me about this Three of Swords, please. Okay, thank you for clarifying. Okay. I said third party, okay. My Queen of Wands is the other woman or the other man, their energies, okay. So this is the third party. This is the Jezebel. You know, whoever this is, they're very attracted to them. This person's very good looking, beautiful. They just have something about them that they really like. So yes, this literally clarified the Three of Swords for me. This is the other woman or the other man. And once again, your ex is giving this cup of love to the Queen of Wands behind the third party's back. So that is what's going on. This is what the sneaky energy is. It's like they're stuck in a relationship they don't want to be in. And they've got themselves stuck in a situation that they don't want to let go of. And they're trying really hard that, you know, to keep this a secret. This is why their energy is very sneaky at the moment, you know, and they're doing the deed. Somebody else. We do have Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. We do have Aries, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. I did forget to say that next door, but never mind. And we do have Pisces. So let's get a bit more information. So tell me a bit more, please. Tell me a bit more about the third party and group two's ex here. We do have the Five of Cups, we have the Ace of Cups, the King of Pentacles, and the Five of Pentacles. And the Eight of Wands, there's that Seven of Wands again. There's a lot of communication going backwards and forwards between this Queen of Wands, okay? I feel, actually I want to clarify, wait a minute, sorry. There is something I'm seeing here, but I want to know about this before I say it. Tell me about the Queen of Wands. I'm seeing here that I feel like they've tried to cut it off with the Queen of Wands, and the Queen of Wands is not allowing it. Or, yeah. This Queen of Wands wants more, okay? And there is communication going backwards and forwards with the ex and this Queen of Wands. Because this Queen of Wands feels neglected, okay? They feel like, you know, they're not getting this person, your ex's, full attention, okay? They do regret getting involved with this Queen of Wands. Maybe they have tried to distance themselves from this Queen of Wands, but what's happening is the Queen of Wands keeps coming back. So I feel like what is going on here is maybe the Queen of Wands is actually blackmailing your ex here, because this Queen of Wands has developed feelings for this ex of yours, okay? They are in love with them. They want more. They want marriage. They want that commitment. They're also looking at it is that your ex is financially stable, okay? They are the provider. They are the emperor. They are the King of Pentacles. And they want this for themselves. But there's a conflict, and there's competition in this whole thing here, which your ex has caused. And your ex also knows that if they were to leave whoever they're with now, the third party, for the Queen of Wands, they could end up losing everything. financially. You know, the Queen of Wands is not understanding that the relationship between this your ex and this Queen of Wands is not stable at all. So there's your one that group two, this is your ex and their life at the moment. Okay, so we're going to get some oracle cards. Let's have a look. This is convenient with the third party, love triangle cards. So tell me more about the ex and the two third parties. Please go look at group one, okay? I do feel like this is a follow-on from group one. I feel like it's the same energy, but they're now telling you a different story, if you know what I mean. Exhausted, breaking point, tired of living a double life, too much drama on both sides, and this is exactly what I said. Thanks for clarifying, spirit. You know, they know they were reckless, they know they were stupid getting involved with somebody else, and they've done it again, and it's like I could lose everything, and they are really fearful of that and exhausted. Love bond, they still love their person, not leaving them for you, no real issues in their union. So this is, don't forget, it's not for you guys, these messages. This is your ex telling the Queen of Wands that they still have a love bond with the third party and they're not leaving them for you. Wow, hot mess. I can't. Divine intervention. Expect a miracle. Our angels are going to intervene. Ask your angels to assist. But I feel like maybe this energy, this ex here is going to learn a valuable lesson. Maybe the secrets are going to come out, because you know secrets do have a habit of coming out, you know.
Oh wow,
yeah, I'd go check out group one. Yeah, we've got the same cards, all three cards here. We're in group one. Protection, use protection, risk of getting pregnant, possible STD. So this energy, this ex of yours, make sure they do use protection with the Queen of Wands. So some of the story over on group one is very similar to this story, but there was a little bit of a twist on in group one. So, you know, just take what resonates. Avoiding sex, trying to be loyal to one person, no sex life with current partner, fear of intimacy. So they're avoiding the person that they're, you know, the other third party that they're actually involved with properly, proper relationship. They're avoiding sex with them. You know, could be because, I don't know, maybe they're so wrapped up with the Queen of Wands. Walking away, leaving someone behind, ending a love triangle, tired of the emotional mess. So this energy is going to be making a decision about walking away from one of these people, okay? Even though they're saying that they've got a love bond with the person that they're with, they are walking away from someone here. But, you know, it's just, who gets themselves in these situations? I really don't know. I just couldn't, I don't understand it. Maybe I'm stupid, I don't know. Maybe some of you lot are sitting there thinking, have you got the energy to do this and the time? Where do you find the time? Anyway, so I'm going to now get a message from the third party to you guys, okay? So this can even come from the Queen of Wands or their actual spouse. So what does the third party want to say to group two, spirit? So we have financial problems, instability, trapped for cash. Now, they could be having financial problems because the Five of Pentacles there, that's struggling financially. As well, having, you know, maybe they made a poor business choice here with the King of Pentacles. Maybe there's also some kind of financial abuse as well. Maybe this third party is actually caring for the children and your ex has the control, okay? Understanding or not understanding, the ability to understand something, comprehension. perception or judgment of a situation. I feel like what the karmic is saying here with this this card here is that maybe they're trying to tell you that I do understand now, I'm getting it. Maybe they've got an inkling that their partner is cheating. At the time they obviously didn't understand because they were all, you know, they put themselves on a pedestal, like, you know, oh, they chose me, you know. So there is some kind of understanding here. Competition, competing, opposition. I find myself comparing myself to you. So this energy could end up going online, you know, comparing themselves to you. You know, guys, you could even be the third party, okay? You know, like I say, what resonates, maybe you're involved with someone that's already involved with someone, if you know what I mean. And, you know, you are the Queen of Wands, okay? But whoever this third party is, they're comparing themselves to you. Instagram groupie, attention seeker, ego driven. So this person might be on Instagram a lot. They may post all day long on Instagram, you know, like what they're eating, pictures of their feet, you know, that kind of thing. Not judging, but I don't do things like that. I'm a bit too shy. So, but yeah, they could be someone that needs that attention. Maybe you guys have got Instagram and you guys are ones that post beautiful pictures of yourselves, and this is why they compare themselves to you. So, you know, oh, bitch, I'm not dealing with this. A difficult, unpleasant situation. So she doesn't want, she or he, I'm saying she, I don't know why, do not want to deal with this situation anymore. Options and choices, more than one. I'm sure you have options too. He's not the only one in your life. And this is what this karmic is saying here, is that you wasn't the only one in this person's life. She or he or whoever knows that they're not the only one in this person's life. So the third party is not stupid, okay? So let's have a look. How is the third party and group two's ex getting on, spirit, please? Controlling, needs to be right all the time, possessive, jealous lover. So, you know, sometimes people can project onto others, accusing this person of cheating, knowing full well that they're the cheater, okay? Been there, done that, got the t-shirt. Also, like I said, I feel like there may be some kind of financial abuse, because this third party is saying that they don't have finances, they don't have the means to maybe escape. This energy could be maybe a small part narcissist, okay? They've got to be right about everything. I hate people like that. I've been in a relationship like that where this ex of mine had to be right about freaking everything. And in the end, you just end up agreeing with them because you're just so sick of hearing their voice. Complicated. Lots of twists and turns. Not your situation. Precarious. I can't freaking say that word anyway, it's that one there. So whatever they've got themselves into here, they've got themselves into a complicated situation, which we've already seen. Devilish, trouble follows them around, tempting, addictive charm. Yeah. You had a lucky escape, group two. So that's group one and all. Count your blessings. Yeah, sometimes one person's never enough for someone, you know. And it ain't nothing on you. I always say to people that do this, and I do, I'm not scared to say it to them, you're looking for something that's not there. I've always said this. I say it to my children as well. Sometimes I know it's quite harsh to say it, but you're looking for something that's not available, okay? You need to look within yourself, because something is missing within yourself. That other people cannot fix this hole that's in within, you know, within you. So you have those people that are looking for this love, and then they get with someone and, you know, lust takes over and they think they're in love and everything, and then reality sets in and it's like, no, I don't really actually want this. And there's that missing piece again. So they go off and look elsewhere, and what's happening is they're going to keep looking. I always say it's something in you that is actually missing, and no one else can fix that problem for you. Vicious circle, pattern of relationship issues, bad habits, no win situation. What did I just say? Bad habit, pattern of relationships, because something is missing within this person. You know, we all like to be saviors, we all like to try and fix our partners and that, and sometimes when you just get older, you just fix yourself, you go fix yourself. Oh, it just becomes draining. So I feel like this energy here, when you were with and group two, they projected a lot of their insecurities onto you, you know, made you feel like you were doing something wrong. Even this controlling thing here, you know, they may have accused you just for talking to someone of cheating on them or looking at someone. You fancy that person, you know, that kind of thing. I think all of us, maybe one time in our lives, have had a relationship like that. So we have lies. Cover up, they're trying to cover up their cheating. Thanks, Spirit. Okay, which we're seeing quite strongly. And then we have bad traits, which is there again. Arrogant, narcissist, constantly seeking attention and acts as if they are superior, which has come out even in these cards here. Physical abuse, whether it's hitting, grabbing or shoving, it's time to get away. So there could be physical abuse in their connection with the third party, okay? It may be physical, it may be mental, emotional. Here we go again, cheating. They often fantasize about another person. It's only fantasy for now. No, this is turned into reality. Here we go. Cheating again. Double life. They act single when they're not around. Lots of flirting and questionable behavior. This person's a mess. That's all I'm going to say. Absolute mess. Right, I think that's it. Actually, did I do those? Yes, I did. Right, so group two, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please hit like. I appreciate you guys. And you have a lovely day. Much love, guys. Hey, group three. So if you chose just this card here, so with the energies here of your ex and the third party, it could be that this is an equal relationship, okay? You know, mutual respect for one another. It also could be there may be trust issues with the ex and the third party. One may not trust the other one. They may even be going through legal issues at the moment. So let's have a look. Okay, so Spirit, tell me please, for group three, how is group three's ex and the third party relationship going at the moment, Spirit? Thank you. We do have Nine of Pentacles, which is rewards, Three of Cups, Knight of Swords, celebration and idealism. About this Three of Cups. Tell me about the Three of Cups. Bear with me, guys, okay? So we do have the Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Six of Wands. See, what confuses me here, okay, with your ex, Spirit's actually saying they're single. So, like I said, it could have been a legal battle that they've just come through and they've won the court case. Maybe there was some kind of divorce here, separation. So now they're out celebrating and having a good time at the moment. They're just socializing at the moment with friends. You know, business is good, money is good, life is good, and I but I don't know. Tell me more. Is this ex with the third party still spirit? Are they together? What's going on? No, they're not. That's a big no. They've had a separation here. Five of Swords, nope. King of Cups. They've separated, so maybe you're not aware of this, maybe you're on block, maybe you do know about this, but they've had to, you know, we do have progress, we do have finality here, defeat, fascination, okay, so what's happened is, there was a, I do believe there was a court case here, like some kind of separation, maybe they had to split assets and things like that, but they've come out. They've come out on top. So I feel like this ex of yours actually won the court case, okay? They've got maybe more. And I feel like it is because your ex was betrayed in this connection with the third party. So, you know, sometimes different countries are different. Here, like I've said before, judges don't give a crap whether you cheat or not. It's still 50-50 and what you put in. The judge mainly over here looks at what you brought to the table, okay? You can go and say that they cheated, but they freaking don't care. You know, and I do know in America that in some states with you guys, if you guys are American listening, that your country is really big on you can get more or you can avoid paying out more if the other person cheats, which I wish it was like that here. So there was some kind of betrayal here, but they won this battle here. Okay, they had to fight really hard to win this battle. They had to fight really hard to prove the betrayal here with the Seven of Pentacles. You know, the Five of Swords is admitting to yourself that this didn't work out, admitting that they were backstabbed, you know, abused, cheated on with the Five of Swords, lied to. So this is where I feel like at the moment your ex is actually concentrating on themselves. Because somebody in this connection, like I said, that, you know, Three of Cups can also be a third party, okay? Maybe the third party cheated on your ex. Because the Knight of Swords, I'm seeing this card here with the two girls in the card here is being two people. They're holding hands here. Now, what I'm seeing here is that I feel like the third party was actually reckless and that, you know, they mess everything up by getting involved with somebody else. I do want to clarify that card. I love these cards. Do you know, I've totally forgot I even had these. I've had these for years, for about 2 years, and I'm up here getting ready for the reading. I'm like, oh my God, let's use them. Abundance. Tell me more about this Knight of Swords. Abundance, you know, this is the Ace of Pentacles, okay? This is them looking elsewhere because maybe this person that they got involved with could offer more, you know, that they were more financially sound. Yeah, look, they went off in a new beginning here. The Fool and the Chariot. They were exploring somebody else here. Yeah, look. Oh, but they regret it. I mean, look at this regret. Absolutely love these cards. Keeping these out. Sorry, the reason why I'm so fascinated with these cards is because I actually have some tattoos that look very similar to this. I love stuff like this. Okay, I just love things like this. Don't hate. But yeah, they regret cheating on your ex. They left your ex. There was cheating, then they left because they were getting this new beginning here with the Ace of Pentacles, which is maybe financially more stable. I've got a funny feeling, okay? I want to clarify this. Six of Wands. I've got a funny feeling the third party had to pay out your ex. You know, when I said sometimes it depends on who cheated and, you know, sometimes it turns out the other person has to pay the one that got cheated on. You know what I mean. So yeah, this person, this third party left your ex to be with somebody else. Okay, let me get these. I want to clarify the Six of Wands. Tell me about the Six of Wands. What did Group Prezex win? Okay. Tell me about this Six of Wands. Eight of Swords. Tell me about this Six of Wands. Six of Cups. Six of Pentacles again. Your ex experienced a really big tower moment in their life, okay? Something that they thought was a solid connection here, something stable. They realized that it wasn't stable, it wasn't solid, okay? They were literally with somebody that was reckless, as I said. This put them in the Eight of Swords here. This ex of yours went through a lot of depression. They went through a really, really hard time. And now they're stuck in their head about the past here. I'm wondering whether the past is you, Group Three. Because this is a, you know, reconciliations and nostalgia about the past, you know, the memories that you shared with someone. But this is something that you shared when you were younger, or, you know, when you were innocent. This is like an innocent love. But you're not really telling me about this victory. Tell me about the victory here, please. Spirit, what did the ex... point. Five of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles again, Ace of Wands, yep. Five of Wands, Five of Swords. They went through a really hard time here. There's a Queen of Cups, so we do have the King and Queen of Cups. This energy went through it. They're feeling better now, but their emotional state was really not in a good place, okay? They were depressed. They may have struggled financially here with the Five of Pentacles. Maybe it was that the third party was the one that was earning more, you know, financially more stable, had a better paying job here. And then obviously what's happened is, you know, this person's had to pick themselves up. They're single. We're seeing this here. But something happened here where it backfired on the third party with the Five of Pentacles. Now they are experiencing the poverty here. This is them getting this new start, okay? I feel like they've had to build themselves back up again, though. There may be something that they started creating, okay? They may have started a business for themselves, because with the Ace of Wands and the Nine of Pentacles, this is someone that can own their own business. They've started something that is now starting to pay off. You know, there was a lot of competition in whatever it is that they were wanting to create here. Yes, there's competition, but now it's like they're coming out on top. But their idea as well was to defeat this Queen of Cups here. It's like they had a vendetta against this Queen of Cups here. They really wanted to destroy the Queen of Cups. Yeah, what I'm picking up here, guys, I really do believe that this energy here ended up having to struggle financially for a while, fight through courts, and then end up coming out better for it. Okay, let's have a look. Tell me more about the ex and the third party, please, Spirit. Prove it. I've got 99 problems. Not confessing unless caught. Determined to keep both. They are gaslighting you. So now I'm picking. This is going to be coming from their the third party to your ex now, because this is the other way around. It's not your ex actually doing the cheating. It's the third party that was doing the cheating. Okay? So, like the third party saying, unless I'm caught, I'm not confessing. So he could have even been with this ex of yours. They may have even got a private investigator, you know, someone to get that proof. Because they may have felt like they were going crazy in the connection. You know, gaslighting is a bloody horrible thing. So they, you know, I mean, come on, we've got the Five of Pentacles twice. This person's mental health was at rock bottom. Okay, this ex of yours was at rock bottom. But what happened was they got the proof and they won. Because we do have regret here from the third party. Clarity, gaining a new perspective, mental clarity, getting rid of distractions. So yeah, they, you know, they now realize what it was all about, their relationship. Half truths, there's more to the story, secrets and lies, not who they claim to be. Yeah, they got involved with I feel like devil energy. Oh wow, look at this, look at the way she's begging, desperate. Can't let go, desperate for love, fear of ending the relationship. So, you know, I feel like this Six of Wands as well may actually be the third party wanting a reconciliation with your ex here, but they're not having a bar of it, okay? Longing to be together, missing you, nostalgia, suffering in silence. There you go. Thank you, Spirit. That literally clarified word for word what I said. Do want to clarify this, actually. I do believe they are thinking about you, group three. But they're suffering in silence. Maybe you've already moved on. Maybe it's been years. Maybe they know they can never come back because, you know, the audacity. Hot and cold. On and off relationships, sending mixed signals. Don't know what they want. So that's the person they're involved with. So just bear with me a minute. Tell me about the Six of Cups, please, Spirit. The group three, tell me about the Six of Cups. Look at this, new beginning. Queen of Cups. You know, this really does make a lot of sense here with the Five of Swords and the Queen of Cups down here as well. It's like, I'm just getting this overall energy of such sadness that I messed things up. You know, they now realise that you were the one that was giving and very loving and loyal, okay? You were mature, you were caring. You would have done anything for this ex of yours here, and they just took advantage of your kindness. And now look what we got here, the Ace of Pentacles. They're wanting a new beginning with you. Okay. So, yeah, that is sad. Now I want to get a message from the actual third party to you guys, okay? So what message does the third party have for group three? This is not your ex, this is the third party. Oh, okay, not wanting to come out. Jealousy and insecurity. So the karmic is telling you that they feel very jealous and insecure. Maybe they always knew that this ex of yours still loved you, still, you know, reminisced about you. Comparison, likeness, so there you go. Comparison, likeness, similarity. The action of declaring something to be untrue. The quality of being similar or equivalent. So this is what this energy is doing. The third party is comparing themselves to you. Scam lightly, block calls playing on your phone. So, this karmic is actually telling you that they've been blocked by your ex here. I feel like you've just totally cut this ex, a third party off. Jealous, envious, trying to be like you. Okay. You are not the only one. He will cheat with anything that moves. Save yourself. That's BS. you know why? Because this card, this third party still knows that this person has a lot of love for you and happy memories with you. And then this karmic's coming in trying to manipulate the reading by saying, oh, you know, he would cheat. But really, we know, third party, that it was you that cheated. Controlling behavior, including giving unwanted advice, ordering or withholding money for affordable expenses in order to control. And this is what I was trying to say. I'm not good at explaining things because, you know, when I was trying to say about this energy, your ex struggling financially and stuff, I feel like because the third party had the control of the money, had a better paying job, this is what the third party was trying to do, still having that control over your ex here by holding money, okay? Jealousy, envy, resentment, the state of feeling of being jealous. So this third party is very jealous of your ex moving on with their life, obviously jealous of you. Why, you know? So let's have a look. Tell me more about this ex and the third party's relationship, please, spirit. What was it like? Tangled web, convoluted. That's the word. Can't read. Justifications, caught up in trance. Okay. So this third party got themselves caught up in a tangled web, you know. Okay. Got. Fierce temper, too many anger issues, dark moods, abusive. Now we have seen abuse coming out quite a lot here. So I do feel like it wasn't your ex that was abusive. I do feel like the third party was the abusive one. They may have, you know, lash out. Instead of communicating. Being burned, afraid to love someone again, unhealed trauma runs away. So this is your ex is someone that I feel like is very fearful of ever getting involved with anyone again, maybe ever trusting anyone. I do feel like they got burned, you know. This could be their karma here. Bottled up, many unexpressed emotions, time bomb, holding back. This is the thing as well, I feel like they've bottled. We've seen that here anyway. They're bottling up how they feel about you. The regret that they have for maybe what they did to you. Am I missing anything? Yeah, one more. So tell me more about the ex and the third party. Wow. Lies, cover up. They are trying to cover up their cheating. Some, you know, maybe it was the your ex was the one that was cheating. It also could be the third party here because they said they were cheating, you know. But it mainly is to do with the third party and your ex here, okay? Because we've been nosy into their lives. Manipulation. They'll let you speak first to look for weaknesses and establish a baseline. Yeah, I feel like your ex suffered some serious mental abuse here. I feel like this ex, third party was a master gaslighter, okay, that they were so convinced of what this third party was saying to them. And this is the problem. This energy here was, hang on, what card was yours? Was yours the magician, or was that pile two? Yeah, I'm just seeing this person as a magician, you know, someone who is really clever, can look at those weak spots on a person and just like literally pounce, you know. And people get pleasure in that. You see the pleasure on their face. Secret money. They have a secret credit card or hidden money that they're hiding from you. And this was the thing. This is what I kept seeing up here. It was something. This third party had more than your ex, and this is why they were in court. Oh no, it's justice for this pile, sorry. They were in court for getting back at this ex, getting more than the ex. I don't know. Sneaky behavior, gossip. They are complaining about you to others. So the third party was complaining about your ex. So here we go. We do have abuse, mental abuse. There you go. They gaslit you or send mixed signals. So I said master manipulator, this person. Manipulation again. They say one thing but do another, giving mixed signals. This is all coming from the third party. Using you, they only need you when they need something, so they have bad motives with your ex. Control, their controlling behavior comes from their insecurities. That's an excuse. Lies, pathological liar. They lie to you on a regular basis. It's best to let them go. And this is the problem. They ended up with someone that I feel like taught them a really, really, really big lesson. I'm surprised that I'm surprised the devil energy didn't come out with this reading, you know. So group three, I'm going to leave it there. If this reading resonated for you, please hit like. I appreciate you guys, and you have a wonderful day. Much love.